Imagine if every car on the road disappeared for an entire month. Sounds surreal, right? Well, that's how much CO2 we could save annually if we transitioned to hydrogen-powered engines. As the world revs up its engine for a cleaner future, a new titan emerges in the automotive landscape, Cummins hydrogen engine. In this video, we will dive into the latest technologies expected to revolutionize the automotive industry in the near future. And while you're at it, then not forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Without further ado, let's get into it. A recent development that came as a major shock to many automobile manufacturers is the latest emission standard introduced by EPA that would take effect in 2027. The featured regulations would be the most stringent ever set for diesel engines, and they are expected to reduce harmful emissions by up to 90%. This policy has certainly posed a significant setback for the relevant industry and has disappointed many, but Cummins is not to be defeated anytime soon. Being one of the leading corporate players in engine manufacturing, the company is in the process of developing the ultimate beast, the Cummins hydrogen engine. Cummins has introduced a hydrogen variant of its well-known B6.7 engine, which serves as the foundation for the existing 6.7-liter Cummins inline six-cylinder turbocharged diesel engine utilized in Stellantis Ram pickup trucks. This engine is currently featured in the heavy-duty series 2500, 3500, 4500, 5500 of Ram pickups. Moreover, Cummins H2 ICE engine incorporates a high-capacity hydrogen storage system operating at 700 bar, that's 10,000 psi pressure, extending operational hours between refueling cycles. This setup enables the vehicle to achieve a travel range of approximately 300 miles. Within the medium-duty truck configuration, the 6.7-liter hydrogen-powered B6-7H engine generates 290 horsepower and a torque of 886 pound-foot. Moving on, Cummins recently unveiled a versatile 15.0-liter engine platform during the Cannes Expo, capable of utilizing hydrogen, biogas, and advanced diesel technologies. This innovation provides original equipment manufacturers the chance to expedite the reduction of carbon emissions in heavy-duty, off-highway vehicles. The platform is engineered to meet forthcoming strict emission standards while delivering notably higher power density within a more compact installation space. This empowers OEMs to enhance productivity without affecting operational expenses. The standout feature of the new 15-liter hydrogen engine is a double overhead camshaft, DOHC, realizing significant advances in combustion and thermal efficiency. It employs direct injection and lean burn combustion, which will be accessible in power ratings ranging from 400 to 530 horsepower and a peak torque of 2600 Nm. The 15-liter advanced diesel variant, on the other hand, showcases Cummins' latest XPI ultra-high pressure fuel injection system and will provide a wide power spectrum of 450 to 675 horsepower, accompanied by a peak torque of 3,000 Nm. Using B100 biodiesel can yield up to 70% reduction in carbon emissions, while adopting HVO renewable fuel can achieve up to an impressive 90%. In uses propelled by renewable biogas, the 15-liter natural gas iteration will offer power ratings spanning from 400 to 510 horsepower, 298 to 380 kilowatts, and a peak torque of 2,500 Nm. An additional advantage of this engine is its notably low noise levels, particularly advantageous for operations within urban settings. Now, the Cummins hydrogen engine isn't an ordinary development. It has massive implications, not only for the energy sector, but also for traditional diesel engines. Just to get started, Cummins claims its groundbreaking product can be a zero-emission solution for commercial vehicles and equipment. The engine is based on Cummins' existing diesel engine technology, but it has been modified to run on hydrogen fuel. Bold claims, some might say, although time will tell if the Cummins hydrogen engine can live up to the hype. Experts have expressed their reservations regarding the feasibility and practicality of this engine. But before we get into that, let's talk about what makes this engine so special. One cannot ignore its plus points compared to the traditional fossil-powered combustion engines, and even other zero-emission technologies like battery electric vehicles and fuel cell electric vehicles. To give you an idea, BEVs rely exclusively on rechargeable batteries to store electrical energy. They use electric motors to convert this energy into mechanical power, which then drives the vehicle's wheels. However, a hydrogen engine is more efficient as it directly converts the chemical energy in the hydrogen into mechanical energy. As a result, hydrogen engines can achieve fuel economy of up to 60 miles per gallon equivalent, while BEVs typically achieve fuel economy of around 40 only. Similarly, hydrogen engines also have a longer range than FCEVs. FCEVs carry a heavy tank of hydrogen, which adds weight to the vehicle. Hydrogen engines, on the other hand, can use the same fuel tank as a diesel engine. Consequently, FCEVs typically possess a range of around 300 miles, while good quality hydrogen engines can go up to 700 miles. In September 2022, Werner Enterprises, a large trucking company, signed a letter of intent to purchase 500 Cummins hydrogen internal combustion engines upon availability. The trucking company sees the engine as a tool to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions. But as there are two sides to a picture, the Cummins hydrogen engine has its limitations. Firstly, hydrogen engines are substantially more expensive to produce than BEVs and FCEVs, reducing their economic feasibility for commercial and personal uses. The average cost of a BEV in the United States is around $40,000, whereas, according to a study by the Hydrogen Engine Alliance, hydrogen engines could take around $60,000 in 2025. However, the study also noted that the cost could come down to $40,000 by 2030. It is important to note that this is just an estimate, and the actual cost of a hydrogen engine can vary depending on the vehicle and the manufacturer. Now, you must be wondering, why this disparity? Well, multiple factors play into it. Let's analyze them one by one. Hydrogen fuel cells are the most expensive component of a hydrogen engine, and although their cost has been declining in recent years, it is still steeper than that of batteries or gasoline engines. Moreover, hydrogen, being a very light gas, is difficult and bulky to store. It further requires high volumes of pressure to maintain its liquid state. Because it is a relatively new technology and lacks a mainstream supply chain, hydrogen engine experiences lower economies of scale. Moving on, Cummins is not the standalone mastermind behind the development of the advanced hydrogen engine. The company has collaborated with various other organizations to materialize their innovations. In particular, Cummins is working with Inprox to develop hydrogen tanks that are lightweight and durable. It is working with First Element Fuel to develop hydrogen fueling stations across the United States. Furthermore, Cummins is a member of the Hydrogen Engine Alliance, a group of automotive companies, industry suppliers, and academic institutions that are working to develop and commercialize hydrogen engines. Besides this, Cummins is also coordinating with several research institutions, including the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, which is a federal research lab that is working on developing hydrogen technologies to test and evaluate its hydrogen engine. On the other hand, testing is a crucial aspect of a never-like-before technology like the Cummins hydrogen engine. For this purpose, Cummins is collaborating with popular fleet operators, including UPS, Walmart, and John Deere. These corporations are testing the popular hydrogen engine in a fleet of delivery trucks, forklifts, and tractors, respectively. This is a huge milestone in the journey of real-life applications of the engine. Amidst this rises the greatest question: can hydrogen engines replace traditional diesel engines? The answer is complicated. Although the Cummins hydrogen engine has the potential to be a cleaner alternative to diesel, it presently faces several limitations that need to be addressed. The primary challenge is the production and distribution of hydrogen. The majority of hydrogen is currently produced through methods like steam methane reforming, which often relies on natural gas and produces carbon emissions. This defeats the purpose of opting for an alternative in the first place, according to some critics. Shifting to cleaner production methods, such as electrolysis powered by renewable energy, is necessary to make hydrogen engines sustainable in the long run. Given this, Cummins has recently announced plans for a new 500-megawatt electrolyzer facility in Fridley, Minnesota, to produce hydrogen gas. This facility will only be powered by renewable energy, making it a groundbreaking carbon-neutral facility. Additionally, establishing a widespread hydrogen distribution infrastructure is a hurdle, as it requires hefty capital investment and time. This compromises the current practicality of hydrogen vehicles, especially for long-distance travel. Then comes the process of producing, transporting, and converting hydrogen into usable energy. It also involves several intermediary steps, each of which incurs significant energy losses. Engines like the Cummins hydrogen engine might find niche applications in specific sectors, like heavy-duty transportation, where long ranges and quick refueling are required. However, for smaller vehicles and urban environments, battery electric vehicles are usually more practical due to their better energy efficiency, simpler infrastructure requirements, and lower costs. Besides, hydrogen is a highly flammable gas and may pose serious safety concerns if not handled properly, risking fatal leaks and even life-threatening accidents. Believe it or not, even hydrogen emissions aren't entirely environmentally friendly. They may release some nitrogen oxides into the atmosphere. This can, however, be curtailed to a large extent by using aftermarket systems similar to those currently utilized in the majority of diesel vehicles. To sum it all up, the Cummins hydrogen engine has promising potential if adequate strategies are implemented to address the cost, efficiency, and safety concerns. For now, Cummins is targeting the commercial vehicle market for its hydrogen engines as they produce the highest level of harmful emissions which need to be curtailed. It is, however, also working to accommodate passenger cars and buses. This may make hydrogen engines more mainstream in the future. Although traditional diesel engines probably aren't going anywhere for the next few years, they are expected to face increasing competition from healthier alternatives like hydrogen engines and electric vehicles. Given the government keeps disincentivizing pollution-causing fuels through stringent policies, automotive giants will be compelled to devise solutions if they are to not go out of business and become history. Do you think the Cummins hydrogen engine has a future as an alternative to diesel engines? Or will electric cars take over both of them? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. And before you leave, smash the subscribe button for more interesting content.